Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at some tips and tricks for using tabs in Safari. Now before we look into these tips, I want you to go in Safari to Safari Preferences and under there look under Tabs, because it lists a bunch of the keyboard shortcuts right here that I'm going to talk about, and also has some settings that will change how Safari works with tabs. So it may change how the things we're going to talk about work. For instance, you can turn off Command Click opens a link in a new tab, and you can also select whether or not when you start a new tab it automatically becomes active. So like for instance, let's turn that on, and then this will tell you the list of basic shortcuts and how they react based on these settings up here. And you can also select when to open pages and tabs instead of opening a window. So I have it set to always open tabs. Always use tabs rather than using windows to open new pages. Now once you have things set up that way, you can create a new tab one of many ways. One is to use this plus symbol that's right here to the right of all the tabs you've got. Press that and it opens a new tab. And then you'll see that you can press it again and you can open up a third tab. So you have all these tabs and you can switch between them very easily by clicking on the tab. Once you're inside a tab, you can go to a web page in it and you're looking at the web page in that tab, and you still have your old page open in that one as well. Now keyboard shortcuts are much easier than pressing this button right here. And keyboard shortcuts are no secret. You can find them here in the menu. So for instance, under File you've got New Tab, and you can see the keyboard shortcut is Command T. So Command T will open up a new tab. And if you want to close the tab, it's the same thing as closing a window. It's Command W. You can see it closes that tab and it continues to close them and move one tab over. Now when you're on a web page and you want to open up a link in a new tab, you can do that very easily. Instead of clicking on this link, which will change this tab here to go to that page, I can simply Command click on it. And now it will open it up in this case a new tab. Remember, if I had my settings different, that would open up in a new window. But you can see it created the new tab and it jumped right to that tab as well. The Command trick also works if you've got bookmarks in your bookmarks bar here. So for instance, if I click on this, it would take this tab to this page. But if I Command click, it will open up a new tab with that website here from the bookmark. Now what happens if I don't have a link and I don't have a bookmark or something and I want to open up a web page in a new tab? I could Command T, create a new tab, and then enter in the URL. But sometimes you just start typing in a new site and you realize I don't want it to replace this page that's here in this tab. I want it to create a new one. So instead of hitting Enter, Return, which will replace what's in this tab, I'm going to do Command and Return. And you see it creates a new tab there with what I had in there, but still left the old one open and pointing to the original page. Now for moving between tabs, the easiest thing to do is just to click on the tab like that. But you can also use Window Select Previous Tab and Select Next Tab, and the keyboard shortcuts for that are Control Tab and Control Shift Tab. So Control Tab goes forward and Control Shift Tab goes back. And then you can loop around through them like that. Easier keyboard shortcuts are Command Shift and then the right and left square brackets. They do the same thing. Now there's also the Tab View. Notice this button here to the right of the plus button. It only appears when you have more than one tab open. And this brings you to this view here, and you can use two fingers on your trackpad to go back and forth, or you can use the arrow keys to go back and forth and then spacebar to jump into that tab. If you go to View, Show All Tabs, that's how you get to it through the menu, and Shift Command and then the backslash are how you do it on the keyboard. So you do Shift Command, backslash, arrow keys, and spacebar, and you can quickly move to any tab. So closing tabs is pretty straightforward if you just want to use the basic click command here, where you roll over with your cursor the tab and then you click the X, and you can do that. And this can be undone as well. You can do Command Z and it will bring that tab back. So you can do this. You can also use Command W to close a tab. I've showed you that before, and that can be found here under File. You can close tab Command W. Now notice if I hold the Option key down, that changes to close other tabs. So that's interesting. If you go here and you say I want to get rid of all the other tabs really quickly, you can do Command Option W And you can see it closed all the tabs except this one. Now if you do want to use Windows, you can do Command N here and create a new window. And I have two windows now in Safari. And I can open multiple tabs here. So I've got two tabs in this one and I've got a tab over here. Let me create another tab there. You can drag and drop tabs between windows. So I can drag the solitaire tab over to this window here. And now I've got three tabs here and one tab there. In addition to that, I close this window here and I create a new tab here. If I want to split this up, so I want to take this tab and give it its own window, I can drag it to a place where there is no other Safari window and it will create a second window there with that tab. So it's very easy to create multiple windows, move tabs back and forth between windows like that, and create new windows from a tab. So I hope you found these Safari tabs tricks useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.